Sewickney has apologized to the First Family kuti avapinza munyakanyaka yamakuwa. Akataura zvakare akati Mike Chimombe naMoses Mphofu vari kumblackmailer Susan Mutami abva auya kuzoataka Sewickney vakati zvamuri kuita izvi. Tinoziya muperero wazvo. Welcome back to your channel. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Nyaya dzacho dziri kuramba dzichikora muto. Wickney nyaya dzake dzekufarira makuwa. Dzamupinza muna taisirei vazve tataura isu tikati achasara ega mumadhaka uko ZANU PF Youth League yabva yauya ichipopota zvikuru ikati weWickney hatidi kutaura nezvako uchisvibisa zita remukuru wenyika uye hauna any position muZANU PF. Zvino yanyorwa nechirungu nyaya yacho alright ngatitangei ane apology yaSewickney or his media statement. At EA, it has been brought to my attention that there are voice messages purportedly being attributed to me, which are circulating on various social media platforms. In these voice notes, I'm allegedly communicating the impression that I wield certain influence over particular authorities of the state, or that I intended to facilitate the making of certain payments to named individuals. In the public interest, I wish to make the following statement in order to state the correct and factual position on this subject. I deny and dismiss with contempt recording the voice messages in question. For the avoidance of any doubt, I have never at any material time recorded the alleged voice messages, neither have I transmitted such to anyone. I therefore unequivocally distance and totally dissociate myself from these unauthentic voice messages. I have reason to believe that these recordings were generated through sophisticated technology, all with the fraudulent intention of creating false alarm and despondence. Sagari kuti AI ya creator zvino izvi arize voice rake. Is sophisticated technology zvechokwadi yaburitsa voice rake sezvarire. The content and character of the alleged voice messages is however consistent with a sustained attack on my character standing as a businessman by two excitable individuals who have recently made outrageous demands for certain payments from me without any legal or contractual basis of doing so. These two failed, struggling briefcase businessmen, Mike Chimombe and Moses Mphofu, are merely overzealous extortionists and fraudsters who solely rely on opportunistic delinquents as a means of survival. If their demands for payments were indeed genuine, the duo should have approached the courts of law for a redress. Saka nyaya yakusarira Mike Chimombe na Moses Mphofu. Asi Scott sakupwanyaka hana kutaurwa nezvake nekuti they are very close to the royal family. No amount of intimidation, coercion or duress will ever result in the unlawful making of payments that are not due or payable by me. I am fully prepared for any litigations or other consequences arising from demands by these two, which are entirely premised on non-existent and lawful grounds. I fully reserve my rights to take stern legal action against these two for conduct that is grossly defamatory and that is well calculated to put my name and business interests in disrepute. Konai Wikineru, kana pasina nyaya, uri kutaurirei kuti pane mari dzamunofanira kubhadhara nemama demands azvinhu zvisina kumbo exista. Zvinoradza kuti there is a deal remari because ukaramba uchitaura uchidaro unozvipiringishanisa ukazvikonfusa. Nechirungu chihombe chakadaro, ei, zvakaoma naimi muri kumbozvinzwawo zviri kutaurwa pano. Okay, I categorically, ei, chirungu gacha, deny having any business relationship with these two illiterate individuals or concluding any dealings in terms of which they would be paid that what they are publicly demanding. I further place on record that I have not, whether personally or through any of my companies, being a party to a contract with the Zimbabwe Electoral Commission, Department of Immigration, or the Zimbabwe Republic Police, as insinuated in the manufactured voice messages. These government entities are available to confirm this position. Ndiani unotumwa kuenda kunobvunza kuti icho kwadi here? Ivo vanhu vangozvinzwira voice richingotaura. Ko izvozvi illiteracy yema individuals zviri kupinda papi? Kana muchidya mese mari, hapana anombotaura wani kuti uyu ana kudzidza, uyu ana kudzidza. The fake voice messages coupled with previous circulated fraudulent documents on the same subjects are cluttered with political innuendos and undertones. The intentions of these despicable claims is to discredit and soil the image of His Excellency Wuchi, President ED, the First Family, and the legitimacy of the Second Republic after its resounding victory in the August 2023 harmonized elections. The machinations are also well calculated to put into question and cast aspersions on the procurement processes which relate to the conducting of the last elections in Zimbabwe. I wish to publicly state that I have not been involved, neither do I hold any influence over procurement processes by ZEC or any government ministries, departments, or agents. Whilst the content of the alleged voice messages is undoubtedly false and deliberately fabricated, I understand the adverse impressions that it has created on certain sensitive offices in both government and the private sector. In particular, one of the offensive remarks made in these fake voice messages is that certain payment was made to a DG and another to MOMS. These terms have regrettably been ascribed to certain offices within structures of the government and have been understood by the public to refer to Director General. The remarks bear an undesirable effect of giving an impression that these authorities are involved in corruption and participate in illicit transactions. It is public knowledge that the only intent of my donation of $20,000 were towards the ED UNZA scholarship in 2023 and the Angel of Hope Foundation, as both organizations dovetail with my philanthropic work. For the avoidance of doubt, I have never paid the head of state, the first lady, or any other government official anything outside of the two donations that I have referred above. Related to this, I do not hold or exert any influence or control over the president, the first lady, and the first family, government officials, or any public entity. I'm an ordinary card-carrying member of ZANU-PF, which I proudly support. Ukuwe Youth League, one of our church, aiwa, iwe wikineri, a woman of ZANU-PF, zvinhu zvacho, a zvakaoma. Okay, I hereby express my deep regret and profound apology to the esteemed office of His Excellency President ED Mnangagwa, the First Lady and the First Family, and any office of public official that these fake voice messages may have adversely affected or drawn into disrepute. I have taken a further step to personally extend my remorse and apologies to all Director Generals in government upon whom the malicious voice messages may unjustly be constructed as applying. For the record, I hold all the DGs in various government departments in high regard. I have known them as men and women of unquestionable integrity and do not deserve having their good standing and repute being unnecessarily dragged in such mischievous yet damaging controversies. Komurume uyu aita zvekunyorerwaka sezvataurwa na Susan Mtami zviri kutoita kunge ChatGPT because zvinhu zvacho Mavaracho akakora muto. I once again extend my deepest regret over this unfortunate development, the extent of which bears the potential of diminishing public confidence in the affected government institutions. I undertake to fully assist to the greatest possible extent in demonstrating how fake voice messages are devoid of any truth. I repeat that at no given time did I ever pay the DG CIO Isaac Moyo or the chief secretary in the president and cabinet, Martin Rushwaya, any money whatsoever for any service. I wish to restate that I am a law-abiding citizen and businessman of international repute who upholds highest level of integrity in all my business transactions. I do not condone any corrupt practices. I thoroughly condemn any illicit, criminal, or unethical conduct in both the public and private sectors. I give my personal undertaking to cause a comprehensive investigation of this matter through the appropriate state authorities, whose findings will be made available in the public interest. When you must baba week now, munoda ani chivai. Tisa tadzoka kuti vanhu vari kuresponda vachiti kudi ngatitangei na Susan Mutami aposta kati weekend we are not school children munonyepera vanhu kuma reserve no type isusu. We know what's AI generated and what's not. We have so many ways of checking. Nyeperai vanhu vari on the ground vasingazive technology. That being said, Louis Uriri wrote that statement for you. You have no clue whatsoever what that statement means. Your damage control game is work. More is coming and ndakakubata kuti dzvi. Uri kubira vanhu vari kuzvitamburira, struggling to feed their families and sending their children to school. Uchitenga boots nema Rolls Royce nemari yenyika. We are not the CIO or Isaac Moyo that you captured. You have destroyed the whole country with your market deals. Don't take us for fools. Those who could talk na Susan Mutami, who was an PF, has taken a strong stance against Wikinew Chivai, a former convict and businessman. Vakati iwewe Wikinew, ah, what he wrote somewhere. Especially the statement that iwe wakabata mukuru wenyika kutiji. And when he walked to the aeroplane, iwe uchibva waenda kunomubabaisa akati, my son, you actually said you are inside the president's office. Chivai's statement have sparked outrage within the ruling party, with ZANU-PF Director for Information Farai Marapira warning that the party will not tolerate such snide insinuations against the president. We take seriously any attempts dziri kuitwa na Wikinew kuti awise Second Republic. Uguo Youth League has released a public statement that evil. The Youth League has noted serious concern, the malicious, unfounded, and scandalous utterances by Mr. Wikinew Chivai, widely circulated in the social media. His mischievous claims, purporting to be very close to His Excellency President Comrade Mnangagwa, are unfortunate and regrettable. Isusa Youth League, we appreciate donations that Mr. Chivai has been giving to the members of our society in his capacity as an ordinary citizen. And although we do not know the source of his income, let it be firmly known that as the vanguard of ZANU-PF, we will not just sit and watch the name of our most revered leader being tarnished by such malcontents for their self-aggrandizement. Hey, panyukwa chirungu chikuru apa. Our president is an open-door policy which must never be abused. We have realized that Mr. Wikinew Chivai has abused his access to the leadership. Let it be known by whoever concerned that our tried and tested leader is a statesman of highest caliber and integrity. Pari kutakonzi Youth League yakanomirira vachivai ku airport inema. Youth League iri kuti iyo vakange vakamirira kudzoka kwemukuru wenyika achisvikira kuBulawayo. Havana kuenda kunomirira Wikinew. Kana Wikinew anga angoripo ipapo mundege kana whatever, yakanga ichingoriwo byproduct. Vaida kubika sadza. Wikinew akasvika akazviita gokupanya iyi. Last two paragraphs kana manyatsodziverenga zvakanaka, they confirm the voice notes are genuine and authentic. And also paragraph 2 iyo ya yataura zvakawanda ikati nimwe vakomana ndakavapa mari ndikazodi mimi vakomana hamufungi hamuna critical thinking. Ndizvozvo exactly zvataura pa audio akati muri madofo nekuti hamusukuda kuramba muchiita kuti tishande zvakanaka tese tigodai. But anyway, idi huchi idi makeke idi delivers pfepfepfe pasine mhandu. Ndozviri kutaurwawo neumwe akati vese vanorwadziwa naWikinew hamupori, garai masiyana nazvo. Saka iyi long read yese iyi yataverenga iri kungotaura mashoko aWikinew ekuti iye haana waakabira, uye nyaya dzana Mike Chimombe na Mpofu inyaya dzenema. Do leave your comments on what you think. Chirungu chakawandisa guys ndakutonzwa musoro izve zvichirega ndichimwa mapiritsi ndigone kuzorora nekuti anonzwisisa AI generation murume uyu ndoyamubatsira kunyora chirungu.